Hey guys, this is Fei Wu from Feisworld Media, and as we're in the search for streaming software, especially multi-stream sim or multicast, which means you stream from one platform and then it goes out to multiple destinations, such as, you know, Twitch, YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook page, Facebook group, but there are a bunch of others as well. I've explained in another tutorial on how to use Caster, and Caster has something like 17 different destinations. I'm really interested in learning more about Restream, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to get started, including login, download, and setup, and all that jazz. Well, let's get started. First, you need to create an account, and I like to just keep things simple so I can remember it. When you first arrive at Restream, you are welcomed with adding channels that you want to broadcast to. I really like Restream from the start because it includes LinkedIn, and this option is very important for small businesses like myself and a lot of my clients as well. So let's go ahead and add a channel. Look, and there's get more power from Restream, and there's an option to upgrade. But look at the services that you can connect with, or Facebook Live, Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, or Periscope. LinkedIn is in beta right now. YouTube. Oh, YouTube events versus YouTube stream now. Those two are different. So I'm going to just scroll down. There's some of the Chinese platforms as well. I'm kind of, Bilibili, that is up and coming. That is quite something there. I'm surprised to see these as options. And I am personally not as familiar with these ones down here. So I want to connect with at least the personal Facebook page. And here, I always double check, you know, when I connect these services to my Facebook page. At the end of the day, it's my company page or my personal page. You want to make sure you give them a right access. Would like to post content on your timeline on your behalf? Who can see the stream post to your timeline? I would say, to me, friends of friends or the public, that's both okay. Because I do so much on YouTube, I am pretty comfortable. However, if you feel like for you, making it private is better, also depending on the type of content that you're streaming, then certainly consider an option that's different from me. Choose what to allow. Here, you got to be careful because especially if you're like me who manages other people's pages, you want to make sure you select the one that's for your brand. So check it out. I'm only doing it for Feisworld Media right now. From here, you can edit the channel setting. You can choose whether you want to broadcast on your personal profile or the public page or the group. But basically, these are the three options that I selected just now. Continuous live stream. This means that streaming past Facebook 8-hour limit, but a recorded version is in store to your page after the stream ends. So apparently there is a streaming limitation on Facebook. I cannot imagine anybody who would stream for more than 8 hours, but trust me, those people exist. A lot of gamers do, and I certainly know people in China who do this. For me, at the most, it would be 1.5 to 2 hours. So I'll just check this. So once you confirm that, get started, you can add more channel. I certainly want to have more than one, but here you are able to see that, these keys, so these URLs and stream keys are very important and also confidential, and that's why they're hidden. And this is what you're going to use to plug into your Zoom custom feed. So streaming software and the webcam is new, let's see. Enter Live Studio. This means you can stream directly from the browser. So let's see what happens. Access to my camera. So you can do this directly. Down here, let's see some of these options. You can disable the camera, but what's the point? And you can mute yourself. You can turn on share screen. All right, I'm going to click cancel. Ooh, you can invite guests. This is very cool. You can have up to 4 people in stream. Need more? I'll apply for early access if you need more people. But so far, this works. And what worries me just a little bit is I want to make sure that if I use Restream, then the recording can be accessed at some point. All right, this is good to know. Let's see what else that we have access to over here. So you have something called captions. Restream allows you to stream up to live on 30 different platforms. Follow us on Twitter, and here you can give it a caption before you share. There are different graphics. You can certainly upload your own logo. That's cool. So that gives you kind of a little bit of a OBS access and look and feel. You can upload your own background. I'm sure some people want to do that. And finally, the setup, title, and description. After you set up your destination, review your streaming info. You can then go live using our webcam or streaming software. Destination only. All right, let's go ahead and add all the other ones. So definitely interested in connecting Twitch. Twitch was such an easy add-on, right? So there's a little toggle here that you can turn it on and off. And then there's a little gear button. You can remove the channel or edit settings specific to the channel. Go ahead and also add YouTube. I would say I'll do YouTube stream. So this is YouTube's new and fast growing platform. Ability to archive the video. So that's cool. So I'm going to connect my account. Make sure you use the right email address and make sure you choose your YouTube channel. Click on allow. So let's add more. So it looks like for LinkedIn, you also have the option to live stream directly to your personal page or your company page. That message just now was that company page has some limitations to who can stream, how many people can stream. Okay, look, after you set up your destination, review your streaming information, you can go live using your webcam or streaming software. So for those of you who want to do this through your regular Zoom meeting, this will be really interesting. And I've not used their webcam. I feel slightly skeptical, you know, and also let's take a look at what it looks like. I'm going to open up an incognito window. You know, see what the guests might see. So first, I'm going to take a screenshot. So anybody who received this from me, that it's important that they know this. So microphone, camera, the answer is yes. And then you're connecting. So now there's going to be two of me on screen. Right? Hello? You see the echo? Only the host can see you. The host may add you to the broadcast at any time. Be ready. The host can also mute your microphone. Okay, great. Oh, look at that down here. You can see who's on air, and this is the guest. Now both people are on air, and you can change the orientation to have like a bigger background over here. Well, you can have them fill the screen, so it's vertical really. I think this will work really well for people who are joining using their phone. And so the host can literally turn somebody on and off using that. So I like this. I like this. So I'm going to, let's see what happens if the person leaves, right? Like that. So the person leaves. See, now it's just me, just the host left on the screen. There's some additional settings, audio input. Ooh, it's a default. So make sure I select typically that. And then this is how you can choose between different cameras. If you're going to do this to interview other people, it's really important to, you know, get all these logos, overlay, background set up, primary colors all set up before, you know, I would say do that as soon as possible. Let's take a look at pricing. Why not? How bad is this, right? Let's go to upgrade now. Oh, so the next option up is $49 a month. That is not cheap. If you pay annually, it's going to be $40 a month. And it's $500. So I would say really for small businesses, I think this will get you pretty far. Now let's take a look at chats, unlimited communications with your audience. And you can embed this in stream. And this is what it will look like. You can use it on a mobile app. You can use it in a browser. I think as part of this webcam here, as part of the Live Studio, you can actually access chat directly here. And you can, I think Restream will basically aggregate all the messages here, but also say that you cannot post messages to some destinations. And here is a list of supported platform. You can read them all, but you cannot reply to Facebook personal profile or groups. Or LinkedIn. Facebook doesn't allow posting comments from your profile. If you want viewer comments to show up, you need to make your stream public on Facebook. All right, great. So there is a way to make that happen, but there's an extra step, basically. I'm pretty sure groups is probably the same. No longer allows access to information about members of a group. So no, this one you cannot get around. And lastly is to take a look at LinkedIn. LinkedIn doesn't allow posting comments. And the profile visibility In LinkedIn setting is set to offer comments will look like this. Okay, great. So that's definitely good to know. Let's move on to analytics. I won't have any analytics to show, but at least I want to show you guys what this platform looks like. Last session, all sessions, and people who go live regularly, I can imagine that this will be a pretty big deal. Stream recorded videos. Completely steps to schedule your live events. Scheduler. Okay. So this is a unique solution for live streaming. The event will go live at the selected time. Please make sure your scheduler video are optimized for streaming. Run them through Handbrake. Use this guide. Some videos may not be streamed without additional preparation. That's good to know. I think what it means is if the video is of, you know, ultra 4K, ultra HD or things like that might not stream smoothly. I'm going to just keep this guide open and then include it in a link below just in case you don't, just in case we all have this information ready. Look at that. So this is actually not streaming. This is not live streaming then. It's more like schedule your live event. Free for video up to 1 gigabyte. So you could potentially pre-record something and call it a live event, but it's not actually live. I think that's what it means. And these are the channels on Restream. This is create an event. This event will go live at the selected time. And you can do this. A demo video to avoid issue with your live stream. Ensure all files over 2 gigabyte are scheduled at least 2 hours in advance. So if you have a long video, I mean, you don't want to do that, upload the video like 10 minutes before you're ready to go live. To be honest, that's actually quite a lot for the free account. What I would do, as I can imagine, is before I go live each and every time, I'll be sure to update the title and description to make sure it's relevant to my current stream. All right, I hope you find this video helpful. This is my first look through everything related to Restream. And for me, it always helps to kind of get inside the platform and look at all the options that are available to me, including the ones I don't think I'm going to use right away. So if you haven't hit subscribe yet, please do. And remember, this is Fei Wu from Feisworld Media, and I'll be releasing many more live streaming and teaching online type of videos. Hope you find this helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.